Hello all. Today we are going to discuss the software test automation and quality metrics under the software testing and quality assurance. So before we begin with the Six Sigma in software engineering quality metrics, let's discuss some about the concept of software test automation. So what we can say, the software test automation, that it makes use of the specialized tools to control the execution of test, and it compares the actual result against the expected results, and usually the regression tests, which are repetitive actions, are automated. Now testing tools not only help us to perform the regression test but also helps us to automate the data setup, generation, product installation, GUI interaction, defect logging, etc. Many more are there. Automation tools are used for functional as well as the non-functional testing also. So there are some quality metrics are there. In that we are discussing today about this Six Sigma. So Six Sigma is a method that provides the organization tools to improve the capability of their business processes. This increases in performance and decreases in process variation helps, which leads to the defect reduction and improvement in profits, employee morale and quality of product or services, we can say. Six Sigma is a term generally we are using to indicate a process of well controlled, like within the process of limit from the center of the line in the control chart. So control chart is there, we will discuss that afterwards. So in between that control chart and requirements or tolerance limit in between the center line. So coming back to the slide, that the Six Sigma is the process of producing the high and improved quality output. This can be done in two phases. One we can say as the identification and another one as the elimination. The cause of defect is identified and appropriate elimination is done, which reduces variation in whole processes. The cause of defect is identified and appropriate elimination is done, which reduces variation in the whole processes. A Six Sigma method is one in which the 99.99% of all the products to be produced have the same features and are free from defects. So this is what we are talking about, the control chart. So this is the diagram of the Six Sigma curve where we are discussing about, if my product quality or the process limit is here, actually the defect free product always comes here. It lives here in 99.99%, which is the defect free. If we are observing over here, if we are observing next, that some characteristics of Six Sigma, which has statistical quality control, which derived from the letter which denotes the standard derivation of the statistics, and it is used for measuring the quality of output. Another characteristics, the methodological approach. It is a systematic approach of application which can be used to improve the quality production. It means DMAIC. This is the methodology that is used for the Six Sigma: design, measure, analyze, improve and control. Whereas the another methodology is the DMADV, which means design, measure, analyze, design and verify. Another one, characteristics, a characteristic, fact and data based approach. The statistical and methodical method shows the scientific basis of the technique. The project and object based focus, process is implemented to focus the requirements and conditions. Customer focus is the fundamental of the Six Sigma approach. The quality improvement and the control standards are based on the specific customer requirements. And the teamwork approach to quality management, which requires the organization to get organized for improving the quality. So these two we are discussing, the Six Sigma methodology, one of that as the DMAIC. It is used to enhance an existing business process, and this methodology having the different five phases as define, measure, analyze, improve and control. Another method is that is used to create a new product design. Remember that the first method, which is enhancing the existing business process, whereas the second DMADV creates, it is used to create new product design or the process design, which is having the different five phases as define, measure, analyze, design and verify. So these are the two methodologies are used in Six Sigma. Thank you so much.